Between July and October, the Ministry of Health, Wellness and Elderly Affairs has been managing the fourth wave of the COVID-19 pandemic. One of the most significant impacts of this is the delay in the reopening of schools. In September, UNICEF approximated that 1.8 trillion hours of face-to-face learning had been lost and more than 77 million students were out of school due to the COVID-19 pandemic. In St. Lucia, we have been fortunate to be able to incorporate blended learning into our schools, but we will appreciate that this is not without its challenges. The experience has varied widely for children across the island. Some may feel safe, have liberal access to food, education, security, and comfort. Others may be hungry, abused, dealing with lack of access to education, or loss of a loved one due to COVID. Schools provide a safe environment for students to learn, interact with peers and adults, establish friendships, learn and reinforce the values and morals that will shape their lives. Given the decline in our daily positivity and infection rates, the Ministry of Health has recommended a phased reopening of schools. What can we do to help our children prepare for this transition? Validate your child's feelings. Some may be excited, others scared or anxious. Children have to cope with all the changes related to the pandemic. Encourage them to talk about how they feel, listen to their concerns, and try to address them as best as you can. Identify coping strategies to deal with their feelings. Encourage them to maintain contact with friends and to ask for help when needed. Stay active and engaged in activities that they enjoy, such as swimming, bike riding, or learn new skills, such as cooking. Your child's routine may be different when they return to school. Start practicing these to make the transition smoother. Reinforce the protocols. Use age-appropriate terms and words that offer positive connotation to help ease their fears. Example, safe space versus social distance. Review hand hygiene, cough and sneeze etiquette. Try to provide well-fitted masks and face shields. Practice to ensure these are worn properly. Although it is contrary to what we normally teach, speak to them about not sharing their supplies, food and drinks. Many children present with atypical and vague symptoms of COVID-19, such as fatigue, headaches, decreased appetite, vomiting, or diarrhea. Ask and observe daily. Do not hesitate to take your child in for assessment. If a family member is having symptoms and got tested for COVID, household members should await results before returning to work and school. Maintain open communication with your child's teacher and principal. Ask questions and seek clarification. Practice kindness and empathy. Anyone can contract COVID. Speak to your child about teasing or bullying and encourage them to be supportive. Approximately 11% of diagnosed cases in St. Lucia are school-aged children, most within the age range 12 to 17. The Pfizer vaccine became available in August and is approved for use in that age range. Even one dose significantly decreases the chances of contracting the virus. Please consider vaccination for your eligible children. Lastly, offer your child reassurance. Let them know that you are there to help keep them safe and that together you will face and manage any challenges that may come up. As our children prepare to return to school, I urge everyone to observe the protocols and let's all continue to play our part to ensure a safe return to school.